Finances can be one of the most stressful parts of our lives. Matter of fact, I'm quite certain that you could probably share a time or two or three where you've experienced some financial pressure or stress that financial matters have caused your life or even your marriage. And so for this reason, we really need to have a good plan for our finances, a God plan. And so the question we need to ask, does God have anything to say about my personal finances, about money in my life and how I handle money? Well, if we turn to Philippians chapter 4, verse 14 through 19, we see that God has communicated through the pen of the Apostle Paul kind of a testimony about the church there at Philippi's use of money. They had received and they were giving. No other church had given and received the way they had, but they were engaged in receiving and giving, giving and receiving. And so we kind of get a firsthand look, a testimony about this church's financial practices. And from these testimony, there are some lessons that we can learn that I think we should incorporate into our own personal financial plan. The first lesson that we can learn is this: God desires that we invest in gospel ministry. This church there in Philippi was giving and receiving. They were giving to the Apostle Paul to help him in the furtherance of the gospel. The second thing, we need to understand that God will reward those who faithfully give. Jesus teaches us to store up our treasures, not here on earth, but to store up treasure in heaven. And I believe when we give gospel-centered giving and engage in gospel-centered giving, we store up treasure in heaven. The third thing we need to consider is God is pleased when we give as an act of worship. Perhaps you don't think about giving as an act of worship, but that's indeed how God sees it. And he sees what we give and what we don't give. He sees the attitude and knows the heart behind our giving. And so we have an opportunity to give as an act of worship, something that pleases God. And then fourthly, we need to understand that God will supply all our needs. You know, perhaps you find it hard to give because you have so many needs yourself. And if you give, then how are you going to meet your own needs? Well, God frees us up from that, and we get to give and engage in giving to help the gospel go forth, knowing that God will in turn supply all the needs that we have. This is a statement we have to take by faith. Every need that we have, God is able to supply it. Hope you have a great day.